Anna Nervegna and Tony Reed, and we're presenting our Central Goldfields Art Gallery, which stands on the Dja Dja Wurrung land, and we pay our respects to the elders from all nations, past, present, and emerging. So the Central Goldfields is obviously an evocative landscape that we all hold memories from, including the water caves, water wells that are Indigenous in the area. Mark Twain said that Maryborough was a station with a town attached to it. And the Gold Rush town has the most massive scale buildings of that era. They're quite impressive with a huge scale. This is our building, which is the original fire station.
So they're each at opposite ends of the axis in town.
And
so this is what the building we inherited.
And obviously we're struck by this beautiful protected tower. And the buildings were built over a series of installments starting in 1861. The tower, 1888.
So when we came to the job, it was just had partitions everywhere, like within 150 years of bad renovations.
Yeah. We saw these layers of time, and because the budget was so small, we felt that all we could do was take things away, and that became our mantra.
Yeah.
So that the building, obviously, outside, we wanted to respect and preserve this colonial history that is so important to Australia, but also introduce an Indigenous component or an Indigenous history through a proposed Indigenous Interpretive Sculpture Garden, which will be built this year. When we were in the building, we realised that there was no acknowledgement of the tower, the bell tower.
Or
the garden. So that became an issue apart from the programmatic elements. So the gallery has the original garage, the previous carriage garage, which became the reception, administration, education room, permanent collection, and collection store, all climate controlled, for an opportunity for new shows for the area.
So, I mean, we got the building, and at the same time, Djandak in Bendigo were given the sculpture garden, and so we worked together with the Dja Dja Wurrung to work out how we could cause kind of communication between the two, and how we could open up the building to histories rather than just a singular colonial history. And so we basically saw this process of erasures, of just erasing walls, creating spatial voids, spatial objects that connect the two areas. So you can see that those arrows there, kind of all the places where we've erased areas and created these spatial voids. So you really feel when you're in the room, move through. And actually, even though John Gulling's photos are really beautiful, it's really impossible to photograph that experience. And that's kind of,
we glazed the existing front door to allow for a digital projection screen, a gallery opportunity, and the previous kind of carriage garage door, which was boarded up, and we turned into a new entry.
And we put these two skylights on the top.
Yeah, the skylights were to bring light in, but we also felt that we needed to connect with the context of the site, primarily the garden and the tower. So the slices became this kind of gesture that we started to establish that brought the program externally and brought the exterior within the building. Here is the reception to the gallery. And the client was very interested, or wanted us to open the gallery to the community. It's not just for art patrons, it's quite a small town, so it's very important when they have openings to engage with a broader audience. And so we opened up the fire doors and glazed them.
Big sliding doors.
This shows the skylights that we inserted that point up to the view from the reception and ramp. There's the skylight and the view of the tower from within.
And the garden door. So you get two
yes.
simultaneous views.
So we saw this cutting or space, we spoke about it as the space being a form that we could create new kind of relationships. This led to this idea that integrating a previous history, a kind of Indigenous history, through the garden that could interlink with this colonial building. And we felt it was really important to try and establish that.
2 minutes.
Yep. There's the skylights pointing up to the tower from the reception. And the axes from within the gallery. We did give them the DDA compliant ramp that turned into a community gallery. We made sure it didn't need handrails. And the internal skylight that looks up to the view starts as an oval and ends as a rectangle picture window.
You can see through here, like up to the tower, through the front door, and then also through the garden. Your footprints.
So this is where the Indigenous garden will be built this year. And we, in the Wataka, we actually worked towards this concept of a moon wall that could relate back to the garden, even though our timelines were quite different. But the planning is going to reflect this moon wall that we see. Yeah.
So you can see that lights up from the side, especially at night time, gets brighter and brighter. So that will, once it's got landscape around it, it'll be really like a sort of giant luminous hand in the landscape. And you see the traces of the old building.
The climate controlled archive and the opportunity for exposing the systems of the gallery through the window, picture window, to the collection store. The opening a few weeks ago. And the workshop. Education room for the children. Thank you.